What's up, sons? It's Blind Run with Son of a Tech, and today I'm going to start pretty much like a total revamp. We have Cavi Lake coming in tomorrow. I have the 7700K along with the MSI Gaming M3 motherboard that's going to be transplanted into my new rig, and then the Skylake CPU, the 6700K, along with the MSI SLI Pro motherboard is going to go into the test bench right here. And so we're going to first start off with taking everything out of this test bench. I have a temp old case. It's actually from that, what was that? Was it Z87? The Haswell refresh that I did. And so this case is really old and really ugly. I hope that I can find all of the motherboard screws that I need for it, but let's get started and start taking everything out here. I am going to be putting a Hyper 212 on the test bench now instead of the liquid cooler from Antec. I have some leftover fans. These are all essentially from the, what build is that? The last couple builds, actually, where I swapped out for the SP120s. So it's going to be kind of hard for y'all to see everything, but hopefully it'll be good enough. What we'll probably do, actually, let's take this off real quick. Probably raise this up a tad more. Oh, we're going to have baby in the background. That'll be fun. No editing for daddy. Alright, yeah, I'm going to give you guys a side view, probably, essentially. Like this. And we'll take out the graphics card first. Sorry, I don't have more than one camera. I'm going to be having to use the laptop here to record the audio. So I don't have everything. But this is the 1050 Ti. It's the last one I had testing, I think, there. So, whatever. And then I need to get my screwdriver. What did I do with that thing? Laha! La ha ha ha. Okay, I'm going to get rid of the cooler first, just because it seems like the easiest thing to do. Of course, I say that, and then completely forget that I don't have anything to wipe this cooler off with, so I'm probably going to have to run and get something to wipe it off with. There's a strong likelihood that I'll be selling this 3770K, hopefully before PAX. But not until we do some tests and see if there really is a good reason for y'all to upgrade. If you're on something like the third gen i7s or i5s, if it's worth upgrading the Cavi Lake over that. I have a feeling that it is, but you don't know. I don't know. We'll have to test just to make sure. All right, let me grab something to clean that off. One of these will work good. I think. Might have to go get alcohol. I have some alcohol. This has alcohol on it. It's just kind of... I've had these pads for forever. I think these are like some of the last few that I have. Oh, the good old 3770K. You've done me well, baby. Oh, yeah. Alright, let's see. Let's unscrew this. Now, these are the long ones. I believe this has the... This is the Antec cooler 620, I believe it is. 620. not a bad CPU cooler. I've had it for a long time, still not dead, so that's cool. There goes that. Alrighty. So we're getting down to the bare bones here. Ooh, USB 3.0 header. Two fans. Three SATA cables. I don't know why I have three SATA cables there. I only have one drive. Alright, motherboard's ready to go. So, let's pull it. Pretty quick and painless, I guess. Not too bad. That's what I really do like this case. It's just super easy to work in. It's great for if you do stuff like me, and it's better than having a full test bench because I can carry it around with me too if I need to. So just lifting it and putting it somewhere is not really that big of a deal. It's easy to get to everything. And that's why I use it to double as my test bench. If you're a tech tuber, you should do it too. Alright, front IO we forgot to unplug. Let's do that real quick. Before we fully dislodge this motherboard, I think we have one more screw. Yeah, up there by the fan headers, by the 24 pin. Alright, we'll take care of that. We should lift. Yep, there we go. Oh, we forgot the HD audio. Come on, HD audio. Try to do this. There we go. Oh, I'm gonna lose that backplate. Can we get it back in? Yeah, there we go. Okay. ASUS PA-Z77 removed. There was a couple things I wanted to do here. Well, we need the I.O. Alright, let's get this motherboard tray out of the way if we can. What am I forgetting here? That's it. Well, we need to pull this power supply anyways. This is going to be the thermal take power supply. Let me remove this. No, I'm still stuck on something. Oh, God. Why couldn't you guys tell me there's one more over here? Come on, guys. There we go. Yay, motherboard tray out. That'll let me get to all this a little bit easier. That should just let me slide this baby out. Other than a couple little things here. That SATA is going to stay here. Or that little controller. Which, I mean, not like I have any drives in there. But whatever. Let's see. Power there. And power there. Alright, there we go. Okay. So there's the thermal take. We need to take the front cover off, or the cover off of it. The P and Y. One of them at least. This used to have a... I don't know where that is. We'll have to find it. I should have another converter too, which would be helpful. But for now... we can get this out of the way and be done with it. Actually, yeah. So this, we're just going to hang this in the test bench because I need something to mount this Raptor drive with, because that's what the 3770K is going to get now. It's a 160 gigabyte Raptor drive. So it's old school. It's the only drive I have laying around right now. That's what happens when you go through this crap so fast. So that's done. That's going to go into this build. This. Now this is ready to go. Should have plenty of power for everything we need. Two PCI SATA. Alright, cool. Motherboard tray we will save for this one. That one, really, all of these will be going with this build. Alrighty, there's that baggie done. You can kind of start. Oh, I did want two screws for this crap. Maybe we can find stuff in here or here. Who knows? Oh, here they are. All right. Get this mounted up. There we go. That's step one. Step two is really going to be finding this is going to be the part that takes the longest because I am a terrible person. Oh my god. That's going to be finding all of the motherboard screws that we need. Because I always put them in a bag and then screw myself. That's what I do. to ski myself. Why can't you keep these organized, Blind Run? You fool. Actually, I don't even care if they're this color. Nope. Jeez. There we go. Six more. Five more. Four more. I think this is one. Three more. These all look wrong. So we almost had enough. Ooh. I think there's exactly three more in here. Nope. I think there's one more. Alright, I need three more. This one must have been a long time ago because I don't remember it. But these are definitely all motherboard screws. One. Three. Alright, we got them all. They're not all matching. They're all good enough for me. They're all black, so. Like I said, I don't even know what I'm doing with this one anyways. Okay, there's that. Alrighty, so here's this case. First thing we gotta do is put some fans in it. Said I had these three. Let me make sure. Okay, these two are the same, so this one's gonna go on the back. These two will go in the front. Oh yeah, I forgot, these come off. Mm-hmm. Makes that easy. Oh, my fly's open. Alright. Boop. Ugh. And close that bitch. That should take care of that thing. And number two. There's that. All right, so front panel can go on. I think I had. Yeah, I'll cover that. I think I have one more. I didn't have a second cover, so for shits and gigs, we're going to put in a DVD player just so I don't have an open gap. Really only for looks. I'm probably not even going to hook it up. Which I don't even know why I care about what it already looks pretty bad. Whatever. Whatever. I should be able to mount under the motherboard. Yep. What about these? These should be able to as well. Well, these won't. What is that? HD audio? Okay. Well, at least this portion will mount under the motherboard, the I.O. Make sure all the standoffs are tight. Front IO. You know what I didn't think about though? Yeah, that's fine. We'll do the, I think we can do the motherboard first. Okay. Okie dokie. Start screwing. That's too loose. What the hell? Oh, man. Those three I thought I found weren't what I thought. It's fine. Luckily, I had some sitting here. All righty, you're all hooked up and ready to go. Let's get front IO done. That was easy. Two fans. That'll just both barely reach to where they're supposed to go. Alrighty. Hard drive. I told you I was putting in there. Sorry if you didn't hear me. No moss. Ugh. This is definitely the most jury-rigged together system I've done in a while. Now the only reason I'm putting all four in here is because it is a disk drive and therefore it'll move around a lot. I don't want it moving around a lot. So that should keep it steady. Okay. Next would be cooler, I think, is what I want. It's going to be a little tricky. I do want the Corsair on there. Do I have enough to put both? I do. So we'll do Antec on the outside. We'll do Cooler Master on the inside. And that should look pretty good. Get that prepped then. Alright, now the hard part. Mounting the rad. Hmm. I always dislike this part. All right, here we go. Here's one. Two. Going pretty smooth. Three. And four. Should have us doing pretty good. I think we'll get some good tenths out of this. Alright, we'll melt the CPU cooler. Let's use the rest of this stick first. That one's almost out. Alrighty. Be right about where I want. They were making crazy noises in there. All right, the Antec cooler is melted. Okay, so we have one CPU fan for this, which we want the four. Well, it doesn't matter, it's a three pin, so. Do I have two CPU fan headers? I forgot on this motherboard. What the fuck? Dude! I could have run that under the motherboard if I was thinking ahead of time. Damn it. But that's okay. It'll be fine. So I think. Oh, there it is. CPU fan. And CPU fan optional.
USB. Audio. I had a red, there we go. Where is it again? One and two are up here. There we go. That's for later. That's for later. This is for later, most likely. Well, let's go power supply. This. Don't need these. Probably just leave it to 1050 Ti for now. Since there's no space, we're going to want to turn this upside down. So we're flipping the power supply since there's not a lot of room down here to breathe. So it's going to be sucking from inside the case and pushing out, which is, it's okay. Okay, that's simple enough. Not gonna look great, but it'll get the job done. You can zip tie it with this. Yeah, sure. Why the hell not? The 1050 Ti. Actually, not a bad build. At all. Alright, last thing I need is the power. Which maybe I should have run earlier, but... If a DVD drive's in there, it might as well work. Which, I kind of did that backwards, but... There we go. And there you go. Here is the repurposed 3770K with a GTX 1050 Ti, ASUS motherboard, ASUS graphics card, Antec case, Antec cooler. Not bad. Not bad at all. All right, hold on for part two. And you guys can get some B-roll of this, too. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe down below. And I'll see you next Tuesday.